What's good, guys? Welcome back to Ron's Rise. Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to another video. Now, you guys remember back on October 6th, probably about 2 weeks or so ago, when we had some spy shots of the Alfa Romeo Giulia GTA testing, you know, out in the rain, on the highway, all that stuff. Well, we kind of know what it was up to now. Gino Vazzi and Kimi have been testing the Alfa Romeo GTA on the track, and they're really just kind of ripping this thing up. And there was a video that was actually released. I'm not going to play it here on this because I don't have the copyrights to it, but I did share it on my Facebook. But I do have some beautiful shots from them testing the Alfa Romeo Giulia. Now, before being distinctively launched for the very lucky owners who will take one home, given the 500 that will only be produced and not in the US, the development sessions continue, which also involve the two official drivers of Alfa Romeo Racing Formula One team. So that is Kimi and Antonio, and the two dedicated themselves to different aspects of the splendid Giulia GTA and GTAM on the iconic Balocco track. Now, working closely with Alfa Romeo engineers, they want to fine-tune the definitive components that we will see on the Alfa Romeo sedans. Specifically, the Iceman took care of the aerodynamics, while Antonio focused on the setup. Now, the development of the Alfa Romeo Giulia GTA and GTAM carried out this time in Balocco, and it allowed us to become more familiar with the latest changes made on the Alfa Romeo sedan and their impact on the overall dynamics of the vehicle. Now, as I said earlier, Antonio provided all of the necessary information regarding the layout of the Giulia in relation to the interesting new carbon fiber components and the solution of the single nut wheel rims. Those seen on the camouflage Giulia GTA and GTAM, those are just prototype rims, so that answers my question that I had on that previous video, while the definitive variants will have the classic 5-hole wheels. Now, at the end of the session, an enthusiastic Antonio admitted it was really nice to see the improvement we made on the car. Now, Kimi, the Iceman's approach was a little bit different. He devoted himself to the aerodynamic appendages introduced at the front, starting with the brand new adjustable splitter integrated into the interesting front bumper. Now, consequently, particular attention was also paid to the large rear wing of the Giulia GTAM. In the video released by Alfa Romeo, you'll be able to see where a certain attention, both from Kimi and Antonio, are aimed at the underbody of the Giulia, completely fair to make it flat up the obvious rear outlet channeled through the large extractor. Now, for Kimi, the Giulia GTAM represents the perfect car for mixed use, i.e. for the use on the track and everyday road use. Now, there are new aerodynamic elements in carbon fiber that will be taken care of by the F1 racing team. And in fact, they will engineer and take care of the construction of the front bumper, with the new splitter fully adjustable to different positions, with a new front splitter fully adjustable to different positions of the side skirts of the extractor, and for the two rear wing variants foreseen in the GTA and GTAM. Now, the GTA, in fact, uses a simpler spoiler, while the GTAM introduces a much wider wing capable of generating downforce values 3 times higher than those achieved by the Giulia Quadrifoglio and doubly higher than those introduced by the GTA. The wing can clearly be adjusted manually, as happens for the front splitter, in order to match the GTA and GTAM to the track that will be traveled. Now, all aerodynamics have been exploited, specific studies conducted in the wind tunnel. The new flat bottom, derived from the one already seen on the Quadrifoglio, significantly increases the generation of ground effects thanks to the revised extractor, also thanks to the new central positioning of the exhaust, also improving road holding at high speeds. Now, the new Giulia GTA brings back a mythical name dating back to the 1965 GTA, and that was developed at the time by Auto Delta. Now, today, the Giulia GTA and GTAM derives from the Quadrifoglio variant using that 2.9 liter V6 biturbo engine capable of delivering 540 horsepower combined with a weight reduction of 100 kilograms on a GTAM, which introduces a power to weight ratio of 2.82 kilograms CV. And the GTA will be available with the prices starting from 175,000 euros, while the GTAM with prices starting at 180,000 euros. But what do you guys think about Formula One technology in the Giulia GTAs? And what do you think about Antonio and Kimi, the two F1 drivers for Alfa Romeo, putting it through its paces and really just being involved in the process of the development for this car? That just shows how hardcore, how crazy, how special it's going to be. Let me know what you guys are thinking about this down in the comments below. Now, if you did enjoy the video today, make sure you give it a thumbs up. When you give it a like, it helps get it up in the rankings, and we can have a bigger discussion on the Alfa Romeo Giulia GTA GTA and GTA M being tested on a track by its own F1 drivers. Now, with that said, in case you guys want to help further support the channel, you can always check the description links down below, where I have a one-time link donation for my PayPal, Cash App, and Venmo. In case you guys want to throw a couple extra dollars to the channel, you can also check out the Patreon, be a monthly subscriber, or check out the Ron's Rise merch. You can get t-shirts, hoodies, stickers, everything Ron's Rise. Check that out. I also have my Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram. See everything Ferrari, Maserati, Alfa Romeo that doesn't always make it here to the channel. Like the video of this specific story that I'm talking about today with the GTA and GTAM. And make sure you guys subscribe, but click that notification bell so you can get these videos straight to your inbox and don't miss one. Now, with that said, you guys be blessed. Have a great day. We will talk to you guys in the next Ron's Rise video. Peace.